me, repeat after me. Hare Krishna.
Hare Krishna.
Hare Krishna.
Hare Krishna.
Krishna Krishna.
Krishna Krishna.
Hare Hare.
Hare Hare.
Hare Rama.
Hare Rama.
Hare Rama.
Hare Rama.
Rama Rama.
Rama Rama.
Hare Hare.
Hare Hare.
Okay, before I address you, I'd like to first of all offer my respects to my spiritual master, His Divine Grace, A.C. Bhaktivedanta Swami Prabhupada, who is the founder of Acharya for the Society of Krishna Consciousness. So today we're gathered for the purpose of celebrating the appearance of Lord Krishna. Here we can see some pictorial representations of Krishna, different aspects, different lila of Krishna. And we've also put, you can see the main, the letters, Hare Krishna. Krishna means the all-attractive person. And Hare means the pleasure potency of Lord Krishna. Lord Krishna is a person, and He has senses, just like all of us. We are persons, and we have senses. Lord Krishna is the reservoir of all pleasure and the supreme enjoyer. We all like pleasure, we like to enjoy. We have come here today hoping to enjoy ourselves. Lord Krishna is the Supreme Personality of Godhead. He is the Supreme Enjoyer. And we enjoy ourselves by connecting to Him. We naturally want to enjoy, we experience pleasure, not through the senses directly, but through the spiritual senses, through our spiritual being, our soul. There are different levels of pleasure. We speak about bodily pleasure, mental pleasure, intellectual pleasure, and higher still is spiritual pleasure. The pleasure of the soul is the highest pleasure which we can experience. That pleasure which comes from the soul, when we awaken the pleasure of the soul, it is eternal and it gives us pleasure which we have never experienced before in the material realm. Lord Krishna, as a supreme enjoyer, He enjoys unlimitedly, and He wants all of us also to enjoy. Therefore, He comes into this world, just as He did. As I said, the purpose of this program today, we are celebrating the appearance of Lord Krishna when He came into this world some 5,000 years ago.
的显现呢，大概五千多年前的时候呢，他的出现让我们更惊艳到所说的那种灵魂上的快乐。
Why is Lord Krishna come into this world? That purpose is described to us in the scriptures, particularly in Bhagavad Gita.
那为什么 Krishna 出现在这个世界呢？这个特别在《国家梵歌》里面说到。
In the words of Bhagavad Gita, we will quote the Sanskrit, Paritanaya sadunam vinaschaya chaduskritam dharma samstapanaya sambhavami yuge yuge. Lord Krishna is describing his purpose in coming, that he comes to give pleasure to his devotees.
那《国家梵歌》里面 Krishna 特别说到，他出现的目的之一呢，是要给他的奉献者快乐。
He gives pleasure to his devotees, and at the same time, he also, by giving pleasure to his devotees, he also gets pleasure. He also enjoys.
对 ，Krishna 呢，在给他的奉献者快乐的时候，同时他自己也享受他奉献者得到的那种快乐。
Just like in some of these pictures, we can see Krishna with his friends. And sometimes he's with a male friend, and sometimes he's with a female friend.In both cases, he's experiencing pleasure, but not pleasure as we think of pleasure on the physical or bodily platform, but spiritual pleasure.
啊，就像这个图上看到呢，就是跟他的朋友啊，有时候是这些男孩子啊，有些是女孩子啊，那他出现呢，就是有各种活动，让这些生物呢都有不同的感觉，这种快乐。
Different from material.
那这一些快乐是跟物质、肉体的快乐不同。
Spiritual pleasure.
是灵性的快乐。
The heart is a different consciousness.
那有不同的知觉。
We want everyone to awaken consciousness, to awaken the highest consciousness.
我们要唤醒，我们希望大家都可以唤醒他内在更高深层。
And this consciousness can be awakened by the practice of Bhakti Yoga. Bhakti Yoga begins with hearing.
那这个知觉呢，是从聆听开始，就是宋代瑜伽是从聆听的程序开始。
We do Bhakti Yoga by using our ears to hear the spiritual sound vibration of Lord Krishna's name.
我们做宋代瑜伽呢，是先从耳朵开始，先从聆听 Krishna 的名字开始。
By hearing about Krishna, then our consciousness is awakened. Just as when we sleep at night, it takes some sound to wake us up.
那这个声音的音震呢，可以唤醒我们，就好像我们晚上睡觉的时候呢，怎么样可以叫起来呢？是从声音来的。
In a similar manner, when we hear about topics of Krishna, then our spiritual consciousness is aroused.
所以同样呢，当我们在聆听用耳朵听着 Krishna 的名字的时候，我们灵性的知觉是会苏醒的。
And then we go on and use also our tongue to help to develop more consciousness. We use the tongue to chant.
接着继续呢，我们用我们自己的感官来进行，先从舌头来念诵他的名字。
So the Bhakti Yoga process begins in this way. First of all, hearing, and then chanting. By hearing nicely, and then chanting, then also remembrance comes about.
对，后来瑜伽是这样开始，先从聆听开始，再来念诵。然后这样的程序配合，接着是记忆。
By remembering, then we can meditate, we can absorb the mind properly on the spiritual subject matter.
所以呢，借着从记忆中的程序呢，我们可以去记得这些灵性的关系、灵性的事物。
So Lord Krishna, he said 5,000 years ago, he came into this world to perform his pastimes.We are still celebrating his appearance today.
对，记得来Krishna 在五千年前的时候的显现呢，所以有今天这样的聚会。
Every year, in fact, there's a program held at this particular time when we celebrate the appearance of Lord Krishna in this world.
所以每一年的这个时候呢，我们来庆祝 Krishna
在这个世界的显现。Krishna comes, we said, he's coming to give up all of us pleasure. He has pleasure himself by coming, and we also experience pleasure from his appearance.
所以Krishna呢，他的出现呢，他有他的快乐出现，然后也给我们快乐来庆祝他的显现。
We get pleasure. We chant the names of the Lord.
我们是在唱诵主的名字呢，得到快乐。
And of course, on this particular occasion, it is customary that the devotees of Krishna will also distribute foodstuffs which are offered to Krishna.
而同样在这个时候呢，同样也是这些啊，我们准备的这素食食品也是来供奉给 Krishna。
Krishna is a vegetarian, so the foodstuffs are also vegetarian. Krishna is very fond of sweets, so there's also a number of sweet preparations. Krishna is very sweet, he enjoys sweet food. He enjoys sweet dealings with his devotees. So we are hoping today that all of us can nourish a deeper relationship with Lord Krishna and experience more of this spiritual pleasure. We often waste our time in the material world trying to find pleasure in this material, in the material objects of life. We travel, we've been traveling through many different bodies, different species of life, different planets and different universes, always trying to find out pleasure, looking for the greatest happiness, but never finding satisfaction.
我们在这个世界到处的游荡啊，从一个地方旅行到另外一个地方，想去找到满足，但是一直都没找到。When
we find when we come to Krishna, however, then we will see that everything can be answered, everything is revealed clearly. The mysteries of life are revealed, they're unraveled. We can see clearly what is the purpose of life. Why we're here and where we want to go. So we thank all of you for coming and taking part in this program today. Our spiritual master, Bhaktivedanta Swami Prabhupada, wanted that the Chinese people of Taiwan, the Chinese-speaking people, would also take an interest in this Krishna consciousness. Although we may think that this is an Indian festival, God, of course God is not Indian, but God is the Lord of all the material creation, he's the Lord of everyone. So therefore, Krishna is in the heart of all living entities. He's not just in the heart of the Indian or the Hindu, but he's in the heart of everyone.
所以呢，我们这样知道呢 ，Krishna 不是只有在印度人的心里，或是说只有印度教徒他才在那里，不是 Krishna， 他在每一个生物的心里。
Not only in the hearts of all the people, but all living entities, all species of life, all souls are all part and partial of Krishna.
神不只是在人类的心里面，他在所有生物的灵魂，在所有生物的心中。
So this cultural festival, this program of celebrating the appearance of Krishna, it is for everyone to take part in, without any consideration of creed or nationality or race or color or religion. It's for everyone.
这类的活动呢是不分人种。不是说只有印度人，是所有任何的人都是可以参与的。
It's a spiritual cultural festival.
啊，它是灵性的、文化的。
And it's meant for awakening all of us to the highest consciousness.
这是要来唤醒我们更高的知觉。
And this consciousness comes about particularly by hearing and chanting about Krishna, and also then.We also take part in accepting the foodstuffs which are offered to Krishna.
那这个程序呢，就包括了我们也是想的用供奉 Krishna 食物，然后唱诵他的名字，还有跟他任何相关的活动。
And this program is especially taught to us by, you can see over here, the deities of Chaitanya and Nityananda, which we commonly refer to as.And Nita.
那这个节庆呢，也是特别由我们伟大的 Gaur Nitai 神他们呢给我们支持跟庇护。
So some 500 years ago, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu appeared in the form of Lord Gauranga to teach everyone how to chant the holy names of Krishna.
在500年前的时候，主 Chaitanya Gauranga 特别显现出来。
And to show all of us how we can worship Krishna and how we can awaken our pure consciousness. It's a very simple method, but very sublime method.Doesn't take much it's not very difficult, it's not very troublesome, it doesn't require any great austerities. Simply chant and hear, take prasada. Simply by these activities, we can become awakened to the higher consciousness. Okay, so Srila Prabhupada wanted these programs, particularly in this country, Taiwan, that we would develop also the congregation of the devotees of Krishna, that they can also celebrate this festival. There's a great benefit by observing these festivals. It's a holy day. And Srila Bhaktivinoda Thakur, the great Acharya of Krishna consciousness, he says, Madhava Diti Bhakti Chanan, that by observing holy days, such as the Janmashtami, this day of the appearance of Lord Krishna,Then it becomes the mother of devotion for those who take shelter.
像这样的日子呢，都是神圣的日子啊，所以以前神圣的日子都是被后来被称为假日。那我们庆祝这些神圣的日子有非常大的益处。那这个阿毗弥陀佛就是说呢，我们庆祝这一类的节日，像就是显现日、Janmashtami， 那这些呢可以让我们的生活呢。
So we pray that on this day that you will all be blessed with more devotion for Lord Krishna.